I'm a GP and for 15 years, senior lecturer in palliative medicine at University of Queensland, and also a member of the Queensland Health Working Group on Palliative Care in Children. This debate, over 26 years of my involvement, has always been marked by goodwill. Those who support euthanasia have often seen a loved one die badly. Those who oppose euthanasia have equal empathy for suffering, but they are deeply concerned by the wider implications. For instance, that euthanasia will shatter the very cornerstone of law, which is the prohibition against intentional killing. It will corrupt the role of doctors by making us bringers of death. It will demoralise palliative care as we've seen overseas. And worst of all, it will usher in a new insidious oppression of the most vulnerable, who will see this not as a right to die, but more as a duty to die. The UK House of Lords said vulnerable people, the elderly, lonely, sick or distressed, would feel pressure, whether real or imagined, to seek early death. Even Paul Keating said it is fatuous to assert that patients will not feel pressure to nominate themselves for termination. Now that's the injustice upon which this bill should be rejected. But if it prevails, and if there is that goodwill, then it must at least be amended so it does not coerce the conscience of your fellow citizens who cannot and will not collaborate with intentional killing. And it must be amended, please, to protect our patients from their own depression, their own lack of information at such a crisis time, by stipulating input from a psychiatrist, a palliative specialist, and a specialist in the patient's diseases. Anything less than that is negligent.